Welcome back, everybody. Here's your coverage of the 4PL Cup. We are moving ourselves forward now into the quarterfinals. We're absolute legends. We had them on before, and we're going to have them on again right now. We thought they'd be going up against Fnatic NA, but it seems like Fnatic NA has just been defeated, and they're being replaced by a group called, I want to call them Arosh, but yeah, I don't think it's actually pronounced that way. It looks like Arosh. We're going to call them Rush because it just sounds Russian and awesome. So that's going to be them. They're going to be over on the Dire side for this game. We'll have over on the Radiant side, Absolute Legends again. So starting off with our first bans, Coddle, Nyx, Wisp, Batrider. Now that would be standard. Chen is a first pick, however, not as standard. Nowhere near as standard as... I want to kill these guys right now. I want to completely... kill these guys right now. I asked them to use their real names, and they actually took it literally. The bastards. The absolute bastards. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. I'm now going to bring up their profiles over on the side, because it's not only them using their real names, but it's them using their real last names. That's what they're using right now. So to explain who is who, Miguel is Berg, because his name is Mikkel Berg. We have Miracle, who is Jesper Nealon, so is he the third slot. The Winther is Rye, so that's Christopher Winther. And then Strandby is Mania. And that's Brian Strandby. For all those people out there that want to stalk him, now you can do it. But that is who they are. So the guys are being smartasses. And Cinnamon is the only person that wasn't a smartass. Because even if you change his name to Trolls, then I'll instantly know who it is anyway. Because I normally call him by his first name or his last name, Trolls Nielsen. So if you want to stalk him, now you can also do the same to him. So well done. There you go. All right, so how are we looking at the rest of our draft? So we already got, we've got Chen, Lone Druid, Nake, so we've already got a huge amount of pushing power. And we're going to take out Klinks, Gyro, as well as Luna. Any main kind of, like, filter in behind, be an absolute pain in the ass, and not to mention teamfight controlling heroes. They get taken out in the third set, and then Storm Quap as well as Puck. Anything which will also score around with the Magnetor, probably going to go towards our solo mid for Absolute Legends. With the Nature's Prophet already being picked up, could be looking to pull on that top lane, but may not get too far. Invoker pickup. So there we get our Invoker for our mid lane. Brings us even more pushing, depending on how they want to do it. We could be looking at a Quas Exort Invoker. Go out with those early Forge Spirits, go with the negative armor. At least grab one point up in Wex, and we can do with some other stuff. But yeah, Quas Wex, also another possibility. Have that EMP Tornado. Just the intimidation of having that come your way is enough to sometimes push the lineup back. So who's going to be our last person? Ferocious. Ferocious? Ferocious. Guys in chat, can you tell me what it stands for? Maybe somebody can tell me what Ferocious stands for. Might know. Anyway, Bane, fourth pickup. Control for Nakes. And that's a lot of control for Nakes, actually, when you look at it. Through the Mag ulti, through the Bane as well with his Fiend script. Even if we're looking at the Enfeeble, that's going to hurt both the Bear as well as Nakes, making it harder just to whittle away at these towers where that Enfeeble comes out from the Bane. Also opens up the questions of our laning. If we see Lone Druid go on the long lane for the Dire, or if we see him go on the safe lane, and then Chen, Nakes plus one go into the jungle of Absolute Legends and try and stick it to the man. With the Crystal Maiden pickup, I'd say no, though. In fact, I would say we're going to see Lone Druid, long lane, Nakes in the safe lane, Crystal Maiden, Chen. Jungle to start with, they'll hit level 1. Obviously, they hit the one that spawned. But they'll grab one creep and go ganking up in the mid lane, will be the more than likely thing. And PL is a final selection. There's no cleave, there's no nothing. Dealing with PL will be impossible in the later portion of the game. So that'll be the plan here of Absolute Legends. We'll see if Syndra takes up that hard farming role again, but judging by the players which have already selected, I would say that is a certainty. And it is now no longer a certainty, so Winther, bastard, Ryze, T takes up the Phantom Lancer, which puts Mania onto the Rubik. And we'll go from here.
Prepare for battle.
It's gonna parade them slightly. They all enjoy their laugh. Bet you a Cinderin to put him up to it. There we go. Ryze is nice enough. He's gonna be appearing as the PL's real name. Such bastards. Miracle. I'm having to look over my reference sheet on the side because I seriously don't know their last names off the top of my head. Not that I'll be able to say at full pace. Now we're looking through Orosh. So we have Invoker. In fact, different. Ooh!
30 seconds.
Crystal made it looking sexy. It's not the full kit, is it? No. It's not the full kit. It's a compilation of other things. But we'll have. Shh. Up as the Crystal Maiden. Dubas. It'll be our chance. I can't tell you a couple of these players. Tony Montana is also a. I know who that is. It's a common. It's one of his normal usernames. Damn it to hell. My database guys will probably be finding out this information very, very shortly. We'll have Seymour in the middle lane as the Nakes. And does put Lone Druid on the long lane. Already pulling the bear down, looking to pull it out. Cinderin won't want to let this happen. In fact, wow. Wow. Just that. Costs 165 mana, but with a nightmare duration, it loses the aggro of the creep wave and just pushes everything back. Yep. Oh, I've been told it's a type of bull. That's the name of the dire team. Rockers. Maybe. Alright, so we've got Exort build coming out here from Tony Montana on the top lane. We'll see if he does go with those points up into Quas later on, but more than likely it's there to help up in the middle lane. With an open wounds and an Nova. It's a lot of slow. Hitting a Sunstrike shouldn't be too difficult. And once CM hits level 2, then you got the Frostbite to boot. And that'll help out. And Invoker should have hit that level 2. Yep, Sunstrike up. Same time as we'll have Dubas move in towards the middle lane. So they need that Frostbite up and running on Crystal Maiden. And she's going to get it with the death of these two range creeps. But at the same time, you also see that AL, they fall back. They realize it's the timing for a gank. And there's your Frostbite. Sunstrike, where is it? Open wound, slowing him down too. Sunstrike, it's going to be a little bit too fast. In fact, it can be tanked up mostly by the mag. But they're still able to get the kill and snipe the courier at the same time. Oi, oi, oi. Disaster in the middle lane as far as AL goes. We'll see if they can find something on the bottom lane, however. We've already got Car heading into the jungle. And would you believe, Mr. Berg finds him. I'm so calling him by that now. You're now just going to be known as your Mr. as your last name. So Mr. Berg. How to find that last hit in the bottom lane. Actually, you know, who did it end up going to? It went to nobody, sorry. What am I talking about? The TP came out. He escaped because he didn't do anything. Mr. Berg attempted to, and Mr. Berg failed. Now in towards the middle lane. Crystal Maiden trying to get a little bit closer again. Sunstrike should be back up again. See another crack. So Sunstrike skewers away. Sees him nice and slow, and just not worth it anymore. He's bottling up anyway. Sunstrike's only worth it if you're going to ensure the kill. And he is going to go Quas Exort. So we're looking at a very early push. It just means these levels need to come the way of the Lone Druid first. Needs that level 7 up and running. Dubas needs this level 5. Of course, he'd love it if he can get to level 7 as well before they start their push. And then a quick pause. As we wait to start up again. Maybe this is their time they can change around their names. As opposed to having Mr. Neelam in the middle lane. Too many Bergs. 248. So just a reminder too, guys, what else is coming up later on this evening. We will be doing the semi-final, I believe is the last game of the night. So there's only one more game coming up on the live stream this evening. If you want to check out the details, you can head yourself over to the 4PL site. But you can also just see it right here on the screen. So we're doing our very, very top bracket game. So Ross going up against Absolute Legends. Big Booty still to play up against an unknown. Could be a result in. This is taking just a little bit longer to result in. And then Isurus is playing up against TCM at the moment. DD and Power Rangers still fighting it out. And that leaves Eyes on You. And Commander also playing out. But we'll let you know what's going to happen with the results later on. So Strambi. We've got two wards up here in the mid lane. One from the Radiant, one from the Dire side. Keeping tabs both ways. That Radiant ward able to give a nice little bit of vision just over this deep in down. So sees what the Crystal Maiden's up to. That's two bus waiting for the rotation to come towards the top lane. It's definitely not coming. Mr. Berg. They're still farming up inside the jungle. Looks like he's got no interest whatsoever of coming out. They probably just feel as long as they control the bottom lane, they're good to go. But then again, Ryze isn't really doing that. He's controlling the lone druid, but he's not controlling his own farm. They're just really falling behind. Sitting at 16 for 9 up against a 25 for 9 Invoker and a 21 for 4 Nakes. Radiant's top tower is under attack. This isn't what they want to have happen, especially when First Blood's already been spilt. And it's been against them. They're starting their pull, they're starting their levels up. Mag going to come back in towards that middle lane. Go look for a skewer, see if you can pick that Nakes up. You'll prefer the Crystal Maiden, but both heroes are not coming out far enough to get picked up and thrown back. Not unless it's a telekinesis set up for him. Which could still happen. There we go. Now he's... Oh! Small timing, but you're always feeling the risk. And now Crystal Maiden's out way too far. Skewer. Pull in range of the tower. Telekinesis will hold her there. Dragging her a little bit in closer. Mr. Berg, in the end, dies. So far back past the tier 2 tower, it ain't funny. After the tier 1 tower has already been lost. So 2-for-1 up on the board now. How's that middle lane still looking? Oh, still Nakes right on top of the mag. TP support's coming back. So Mr. Berg returns to the top lane. And there's Dubas as well as Tony Montana fall out. Down there bottom lane, Syndarin. Trying to get close enough for a nightmare. And now falls in range of the tower. So it's forced back. Things fall. And this Prophet still tries to go up against the Invoker. Dangerous place to be. Considering the combinations Invoker's capable of doing. Just to go into Quas, attack, and exort with the Sunstrike build. It's a huge amount of damage which can fly their way. Same as the Lone Druid on the bottom lane. There's our Nightmare, and Prophet now going to TP him. Want to guarantee this kill on the Lone Druid. And with PL getting the last hit. There we go. Farm goes his way. And looks like he is going to rush up a... Kind of looks like a Radiance coming the way of Ryze. I'm saying that because he took up the 1500 gold. I know a lot of PLs will hold on to a large portion of their cash. And try and go into a Diffuser Blade. But in this game, I don't really know if that's going to be as effective as a Radiance. If he can get it up fast enough and doesn't get pressured any more than what he is right now... Then he'll go it. If not, he'll switch over and go into the Diffuser Blade. But with the Radiance build up, just throw out a couple of Spirit Lances. You're able to keep a push a long, long way away from you. Just add that pressure to a pushing lineup. And if a Crystal Maiden comes in range of that Radiance, same with Chen, same with his creeps, you have a really rough time. Cinder and D-warding. Probably thought he'd be able to take this one Frostbite, Sunstrike. Not coming. Invoker. He's got it leveled up, in fact. He's got those 2 points up in Invoke. But he's holding onto all of his mana. Not throwing it anywhere yet. Don't know if you're trying to save it for a rainy day or not. Well, Dubas. Trying to fake out the Centaur stomp. I'm going to say trying, he succeeded. Lone Druid Bear going to go for another pull. And again, this should be Syndra moving into position, then he'll just Nightmare it, and there's no control anyway. Well, this shouldn't be. Yeah, there goes the ping. Wondering what the hell is going on. Syndra won't get there in time. Ah, there you go, the bear turns around, and now Nightmare. Nightmare, Nightmare. He's holding it. Crystal Maiden, whoop, something's going wrong in there. Middle lane. Rubick goes down as well. Sorry, Rubick being the one to go down. Reverse polarity, holding the Nakes in position. Lance gets thrown out, and that's enough damage. Combining up with a Brain Sap to bring down that Chen very, very quickly. And now Crystal Maiden is on the run. Sprouted up, held in position. Wants to munch through with a Tango, but not going to be possible. So two heroes on the sidelines and a regeneration rune going the way of the Magnus. Well, Rubick heads towards the top lane. Four staff, the first item for the Invoker. The defensive TPs of Lone Druid. Feeling like he's being watched, and rightly so, he was. Like Seema. Back into the middle lane too. 45 for 10 up for him, up against the Mag. He's still only 27 for 2. This Mag is really underleveled. How are we looking overall? Advantage is going the way of the Dire side. As far as gold goes, as far as experience goes, that's a different story. Leveled up. And that's 4-3. Really? Really? Come on, man. Come on. It has won. The number one. HP. There we go. Denied. Wonder if that was intentional. If he really managed to bring that tower down to 1 HP. How's Ryze looking? He's going Tranquils. Drums into Tranquils. He's had enough of this bottom lane then. Which means we're going to see a little bit of earlier counter push. And full regen rune. Mag using it to farm up everything he can find. Coming out for every last hit. A little bit too far. So I skewered away before he got frostbitten. But then four-staff in with the Sunstrike. Trying to reverse polarity in. But with so many heroes there. There's always going to be enough people to tank up the rest of that attack. And it's just solid play from the Dire side. They knew what they want to do with the push. Ryze, now he's going to take out the Crystal Maiden. PL Illusions will take care of most of that damage. Or maybe not. Needs to finish the job. There we go. Does do so. Strandby. Ruby getting sniped out. And PL looking for more. Dubus. Oh, I'm hearing an infest. He's inside that creep. He's inside that one little range creep. Kills one of the Dire side. Shame he can't skewer that creep out again. There we go. Now he jumps out. Lancet. Not going to happen. He's got rage, open wounds. He's fine. Spent that time to buy up remaining portions of his armlet. Not the entire thing just yet, but most of it. That's now Nature's Prophet. Able to buy up that Hand of Midas. So the income. Trying to start to balance out with what he probably is going to be aware of. He's going to lose a large portion of once these towers start to crumble. His Lone Druid about to pop level 7, which means level 4 bear, which means demolish on the bear too. Cold snap with no follow-up. Near the entangle to push the Bane back. Death on top. Chen with his nukes. Sun's trying to help out. As a matter of fact, they can't see him, they just throw it in. And now Fiend's crypt on bottom lane. Ryze gonna lance it out. The bear's gonna try and get an entangle. It hasn't been lucky enough to do so just yet. And Ryze will take out the Lone Druid. Just after he hits level 7. The pings are coming to take out the T1 tower in the bottom lane. Don't know if they're gonna have enough power to push this out. Beauty is they're not having to go up against a Quas Wex Invoker, which means they don't have to worry about these EMP tornadoes flying their way. So create Narmia trees, they've got Prophet Ultimate. Prophet also is skilling out 4 points up in the TP. So he's going to be anywhere and everywhere, but doesn't give us much pushing power, only 2 points up in the Treants. Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. But that's going to be a T1 tower lost. It's like no stopping. Bring those trees back in again. The mid lane is pushed out by the Dire's side. That's just Shockwave Span trying to hold this out. With a skewer into reverse, Polarity could work out nicely here. But they need more support than what's here. Four staff down. Skewer, look for it. Not going to find it. Already being done. Skewered away to safety. Can't initiate. Just want the tower trace to happen, which will happen. Tier 2 tower in the bottom lane brought down. And looks like, well, Nature's Prophet wants to at least give the illusion he's going to keep pushing. Which he won't. He's already going to push out too far. Time to fall back. Nakes comes in to defend it. And then up to the top lane. While Ryze goes back into farming. And by the looks of it, he spent some cash. Yasha for Ryze. So Yasha and then Diffusal for Ryze. Agility gain is already pretty damn high, but he's going to go Yasha first. Cheaper item, and also will convert into the Mana Snarl later on. Sunstrike, man, look at that. Just positioning is perfect. Deafening Blast, Cold Snap, one more attack. One more attack. One more attack. Deafening Blast returns him out, and then Prophet. No! Even if the Sprout was there beforehand, he still would have forced off through and finished the job. Because he'll go straight through the tree line. But still. Fun play by the Invoker. Mag now with Blink Dagger to walk down towards the bottom lane to pick it up. What are we getting up from the next? Armlet, full treads, and 1900. He's going to TP in towards middle lane. There's farm to be had. Same time, Ryze was searching for a kill, but not going to find one. Now the pings are coming down towards the bottom. Interesting. Blink Dagger is there for the mag. Are they hoping to try and force an engagement down here? Because there's no towers. There's no advantage to gain here for Absolute Legends by pushing out, apart from just the team fight. And if you want to do that, you may as well try and force it inside the Dire Jungle, because then you can take Tier 1s and Tier 2 towers. What is that line drawn by PL? This is yours, and then this is mine. Only Syndrome's finding some levels in the middle lane. 4 points Brain Sap, 1 point Nightmare, now 1 point up in the Enfeeble. So before, going to help out with that Nakes. As well as the Lone Druid Enfeeble, not lost even after the Rage. And they can look towards the Tier 1 tower too. With the Blink Dagger, that intimidation of the Blink RP. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Something to be respected. But looks like they don't really care too much about it when Invoker comes in that close. I suppose it's like, yeah, I got four stuff. It's fine. Dire's middle tower be dead before attack. The RP is over. Let's see how you're doing farming up in the jungle. We've got a glove up on the bear, which looks like he's going to be going to go for the only thing in the item build so far, which looks like they're wanting to stop the PL later on. And that's going to go into the Maelstrom. At least have a little of a lightning possible bounce. Still get the attack speed because, like, just like Assault Cuirass, both require a Hyperstone to create. He's going to need it. He's going to need it soon. Ryze is getting a lot stronger. Well, he doesn't have as much farm as Nakes. And Nakes also did the same thing. He also bought Maelstrom. The difference between him and Nakes is the fact that there's just so many more of him. And there's so much better controlling abilities over on Absolute Legends. We just saw Fiendscript used to ensure the kill on the Invoker. And that basically ensures that Absolute Legends will take the Tier 1 tower on the top. Nothing can stop this now. At the same time as Nature's Prophet, split pushing. So he's doing some damage to the Tier 1 tower in the mid, while Tier 1 tower on the top's going down, and then TP down by the PL. Farm to be had in the bottom lane, and a Tier 1 tower to defend. Also, Nature's Prophet bailed from the mid, but not before he made that middle tower within deny range. Crystal Maiden coming out with the... With the Chen, Cinder is just going to Nightmare up Dubas. And hold him out, maybe even enough damage. Already had that little bit of a stun. Was that Frostbite stolen? Yeah, 3 points Frostbite stolen. Cinder and Nightmares up on Tony Montana instead. Shockwave, not going to catch up to the Crystal Maiden. Like supportive items flying in. Careful with that courier. Cinder working on the BKB. And then TP out by Cinder. Everybody's out. While PL continues to push out that bottom lane and farm up. It's good game choices at the end of the day by AL. They realize that this is the time when it's meant to be the dire side, the pushers, not them. And their start to the game really wasn't that amazing. You can't stun him, so there's no point. But AL are the guys that are split pushing it out and forcing the battles. Now Ryze, quick lance, no defusal blade up on that. He's going to finish up the full mana style first. Man, he really wants to commit to this split push. Still keeping those lances flying out. But Nakes just steals so much more life back. Blind's being drawn by Syndarin, as well as the Rubick. Gonna leave the DD rune there, just in case someone's watching for it. Not to mention Mag has a wonderful thing called a bottle. And they're gonna come up and then find Montana. So Fiendscript on one, Telekinesis pick up on another, then skewer him up, reverse polarity, ensure the whole shockwave through. Both Invoker as well as the Lone Druid are getting caught out. Two of the three cores of the Dire side. Shut down by Absolute Legends. Middle tower is under attack. So now Mag gonna move into the mid. But no, he doesn't. He moves back out again. He's not. I don't know if he's waiting for somebody to blink into skewer. You can see the Nakes at the back end there. Ryze still pushing at the bottom lane. And that full man to done. Still interested to see why he did that. She can go Yasha and then go into your defuser blade. Sure, you have a little bit less life, but it's not that bad. Normally, the thing you look for when you do that kind of stuff is to bait out. The fact that you have, like, you throw out, okay, brain's starting to slow down at the end of the night. You throw the mana style out and you leave your illusions to push. And they create more illusions of illusions. And it just keeps on going and going and going. So that's what the mana style is meant for. It's meant for split pushing. But you've got two heroes that are building in. One already has managed to do it. The other one, well, I don't know if he's got it on the courier or something. No, he's just so far behind. But both are building up Maelstrom. Which means both those small illusions will disappear pretty fast. So you can focus on shutting down the heroes before the team fights with the Diffuser Blade first. But this is the choice Ryze has done. Fortification going to slow down the Radiant side. They want this tower, but at the same time, AL want the Tier 3 tower in the mid. We've already got Dubas back. And Tony Montana also going to make its way in. Quick Tornado, but a very, very small point. Like, you got 1 point up in Wex, 2 points up in Quas. So the Tornado does very, very little. And they already brought the tower down to 1/3 of its normal life points. And then that was only just trying to get them off that tier one tower in the bottom lane. So they can push the tier two tower up on the top. And the PL illusions just holding the front lines. Dire's top tower. Mag wants them to come in. Yeah, you can see him. Blink early on. Try and make him think that it's now safe. Open wounds, maybe enough to kill off for the Rubick here. No skewer in. And that's technically Rubick being caught in the wrong position. You're on this side of the tree line, and the rest of your teammates are basically on this side of the tree line. They can't get around to help you. And with the Blink Dagger already going down by Mag, it meant the initiation was possible. Now it's a lot of PLs on top. Syndra is moving down to the bottom lane. Well, looks like Nature's Prophet. 3,700 gold. Possibly rushing up that Scythe device of his. So then we add a Sheep Stick to the mix. But with Chen, Crystal Maiden, Invoker, Lone Druid, Scythe device will still be okay. Scythe device is always good. Top tower. But might not be a bad choice to go for something like an Orchid. Silence that Chen the second the fight begins. So there's no heal coming out from them at all. Smoke movement in for Roshan. No real vision here from Absolute Legends for it, but I realize that everyone's missing in a moment. Roshan won't take long. No medallion or anything like that. No real negative armor to help him out. So they're doing it the old-fashioned way. They had a large amount of creeps here that's helping him do the job. And there goes Roshan. So Aegis Immortal goes to the Lifestealer. Going to try and be that unstoppable force through the next engagement. But then again, at the same time, they see him up on the top, and the PL illusions have started up on him already. And in comes Ryze. We'll throw another lance. Nope, he just wants the tier 2 tower. Gonna make more of himself, though. Before that's possible, that's why Mana Style pops up now. And the tier 2 tower was lost. But this is okay for the Dire side. They realize this would happen. They try and split push in the meantime, try and get their second Maelstrom up, which now they have the cash for. Yep, there we go. Maelstrom recipe purchased. And they'll hope that's going to be enough. Well, Invoker and Guess to enjoy pushing out the middle lane with the Chen. It's going to be an interesting time to see when what happens when AL try and push inside the base. To see if it's really doable for him. Because it's pretty open. If it is or not. Ooh, Mjolnir recipe. Has he already got the Hyperstone cash? He does now. Courier, make a quick run. Pick up, pull back. You even see just the timing for the control of that. Could have just been so, because he... Like, just good control. Or it could be like, intense focus. Oh my god, don't lose this, don't lose this, don't lose this. Is that sort of mentality insight into what the hell is going on inside their minds. And the amount of pressure that AL's been giving to them. What that means for them. That's a real PL. Diffuser Blade. Now up and running. So this now opens a new kettle of fish. Yeah, Diffusal Blade to the mix. Took some time. 24 minutes of time. But it's there, but Mac, holy Hannah. Man, this guy's got so much farm. What is his net worth? Okay, so he's got 2 kills, 1 assist. Managed to find 107 CS. It might just be all the towers that have gone down. Oh, Prophet, TP bottom lane, but as expected, full of stuff out. And there goes Nakes. These aren't even real PLs. They're just chasing him down. It's the fake PLs. It may look a lot worse because the armlet toggled halfway through it, but you got to be careful, obviously, doing that kind of stuff. You toggle an armlet, and one fake PL gets one swing in, you're dead. It's going to be the problem for Nakes, too, during teamfights. No space to armlet toggle. But he will have a lightning shield. How's Lone Druid looking? May as well try and pick up that Basher while he's there. Doesn't need to go into the full Mjolnir like the Nakes. Just having the Lightning bounce with the Maelstrom's enough. Lets him counter push and farm up at a decent rate. Speaking of such, somebody found an Ancient Stack. And that'll be completely taken by Absolute Legends. Same time, these PL losers, they just keep pressuring the top. They want to make more of themselves. Attacking the tower won't help them. What do we got coming in now? Go Scepter. Going the way of the Rubik. A mag. Give him another 2 minutes and he'll have that refresher orb up and running. And a mana pool only barely to support it. Right now, I think he's about 150 gold away. 150 mana once he has the full refresh roll up on him. So he'll require at least the arcane boots and a bottle charge. Or at least 2 more levels. That's the other way to do it. Let's rise now with 2200 gold. See that Diffusal Blade level 2 come up. If he actually went for a gank and used his current Diffusal Blade charges. Got 8 of those suckers to use. But AL, they're happy to be a little bit more defensive. Smoke gank time by the Dire side. Let's say at the start of the draft. Ryze doesn't care. He knows in the later portion of the game, no one can stop him. No one on this lineup is strong enough for it. Now the pings are coming out. It's like, Ryze, get out of there, man. He can double walk, which he can do now. And it's away from the Sentry Walk, so he throws out one Spirit Lance, then double walk out, but someone's got a Gem. Someone's got a Gem. It's the Nakes. And TP into the mid. Tony Montana, four staff down, Tornado. Gonna be able to catch out. Nature's Prophet a little bit too far out. The reverse polarity go through too. It's gonna ensure Nature's Prophet gets out to safety. But a hell of a risky move. Needs to evade damage for a little bit longer. 3 seconds. And entangle on the first pause swipe, combining up with the call snap. Not worth it. Not worth it. Nature's Prophet will still keep that split push going. And then just hold Dubas away. While Syndrome will chill down the mid. Finds himself a regeneration rune. Not as useful, but no one else is around that will want to take it anyway. Mag's the only one still with the bottle. Just want to double check the cost of the recipe. 1875. Would have been so much closer before he died just then. Trankle's up on Lone Druid, but what's up on his bear is the other question. Bear's going back to base right now. Nothing inside the stash. Nothing on the courier. He's just basically flat broke. Apart from the 1500 gold, but that's not building into anything just yet. That's a long way off a proper item. The only thing he might look for is to pick up that armor. Still want to see the assault cuirass coming out from the bear. That's a lot of PLs. And they'll just move over and they'll even start farming up Forge Spirits. Still waiting for that change. No replicate. They push out the top lane instead. And that's why Meteorite and Deafening Blast. Tony Montana only losing a large portion of mana as well as life points. On the run, the bear comes out. So those illusions just on attack right. That's all it really is. And that's why bottom lane again is able to attack. And he did end up going for that Scythe of Ice. And there's the gem coming in for Rubick. Also, I like to say hi, Sing Sing and Wagamama, for making me say gem all the time. Oh, Sunstrike, Cinderin, BKB, tries to run away. Stick charges and death. Troll Trap, always going to go through Magic Commune. A waste of a BKB charge as well. Now it's his first charge he ever let off. He only just has a brand spanking new BKB. It doesn't matter for Sind. BKB's good, but really the only duration he needs is 5 seconds. And would you believe BKB lasts for a grand total of 5 seconds? Maybe 6 seconds. That way you got the 1 second to cast it, the BKB, and then use the Fiend Script. That works. How much of a dick can PL be? Block the camp. Gem would just want to walk up here and take a creep. No, he doesn't. Lol. There's a SATA here now for Chen. He's worried about the creep wave a little bit too much. His PL just moves from one camp to the next, just farming up as he goes. Nakes now buys the Basher. What did Lone Druid end up buying? What's up on that bear? He is. It could just be a Hyperstone for now, and it could just be the Assault. It could be the Assault Cuirass. But he could spend that extra cash and pick up the Mjolnir. And then we have double Lightning proc shields. Just a reminder, guys, tomorrow night, what's coming up, while we got ourselves a quick moment. Live stream will be starting at 4:30 tomorrow afternoon. Rock's Kiss plays up against No Tidehunter. Then 3D Clan, we saw them earlier tonight, we'll be playing up against Fnatic EU. And then Virtus Pro up against No Tidehunter. That is the 3 games from StarLad tomorrow night. They'll take us through until 19:30 CET. And then starting up at 21 CET will be the defense matchup. Evil Geniuses. Oh, nice! No! Where's the follow-up? Because there's no AoE combo. Yeah, well played. Well played. Well played. And now reverse polarity again. It was a fake. It was meant to think it was over, but it was already a refresher orb. But man, there's a lot Magnus is losing here. And that bear just beat the living crap out of him, while Ryze trying to stand his ground throughout the entire Crystal Maiden ultimate. But Nakes on the sidelines, they've got to get rid of this lone druid. And looks like Ryze is taking care of that one. Gems on the deck again. Chen, nice pull out. That will save the Invoker. I don't know if Crystal Maiden will be as lucky. Chen creeps definitely won't be. I don't know if Roshan won't be either. Just send those PL Lucians in. Don't let him attack. Let him stay on the front lines, and they're going to tank up Roshan. That works. If they attack, they die. So difficult to control as well once you already attack in, because they instantly auto-attack. But when Ryze is walking around with a Reaver, so he has the possibility, if he gets the last hit in Roshan, to buy up a full heart. In fact, even if he doesn't get it, he'll still have a full heart. So he'll take the Aegis, the Immortal, but he'll have to fly it out in the Courier, because he doesn't want to drop anything in his current slots. There we go, Heart Recipe purchased, and he'll go up and pick up the Vitality Booster. So we get a Heart Aegis, the Immortal, Phantom Lancer. And that fight just kept going and going and going, because no one had any AoE clearance. First reverse polarity, pop, pulled everyone together, did no extra damage. He ran back out again, popped the refresher orb, came back in, did it all over again. The one big thing that was working was the power of the lone druid. That bear was just beating the crap out of anybody he could find. And the lightning bouncer just kept happening too. And they needed it too. Nakes, after he went down, Lone Druid was basically their last major source of damage. Invoker is meant to be the control, but right now, with Aghanim Scepter up and running, he was not really much of a mana pool supporter, though. Needs that scythe device. But yeah, he ended up just being a semi-disabler or a negative armor kind of guy. But only a semi-disabler. He's only got those 2 points up in the Wex. So Tornado does very, very little in this scenario. Refresher roll coming off cooldown again. We'll try and make a play on the back of that. But they have to also realize that most of the ulties are still up. They just profit. Scythe of Ice first, and then goes into Assault Cuirass. This is the way the transition of things. Welcome to Diffuser Blade level 2 as well. All the charges back again. So I got a whole bunch of drum charges, but never used them. Most of the fights you haven't had to run, just stand your ground and just play. So in we go. Mag waiting for the jump. Wards give the vision inside the base so he knows where to go to. Blink, skewer, got one. Shockwave 2. Instant lances, throw him up. Wait for that reverse polarity. He wants to jump back in again. There's a couple of heroes grouped up. He can't really catch out too many. Two heroes and a bear. And then reverse polarity again, but he's got no mana. That's what we're talking about when he's too short. He can do it again now. He's being forced back out, but there's a lot of PL illusion. Skewer up to the high ground. Still short. Reverse polarity. Only catches the bear this time around. Well done. But the bear will still go down. Sniped off at the end of the day. And so is Lone Druid. Didn't try to resummon. A triple kill for Ryze. He's just chased him down. Dubust with the Ghost Scepter. Saves his lines for a little bit longer. And Forge Spear is trying to keep out the rest of Ryze. He's got a heart, doesn't really care. Plus the Aegis the Immortal. So the mid-rax goes down. And rotation down towards the bottom again. AL for the second time tonight entering through the mid. Taking out the fight. And using their rather large advantage to force it through and call out the GG. So one more game coming up tonight, guys. What game is in store for us? I do not know. That could basically be anything. Looks like Power Rangers versus TCM option. As DD Dota, the French, have been knocked out. Well, we could just stick with Absolute Legends for a third game. Go up against a couple of unknown teams. We'll wait and see. We'll wait and see. Either way, should be some fun Dota. Keep your eyes peeled for it all. Remember too, we'll be doing the 4PL final on Tuesday night. And has been delayed because both Starladder as well as the defense are on tomorrow evening. And couldn't really find the correct time for it all, so Tuesday night will be the final of 4PL. I'll be streaming it out on this live stream. I believe there's also a couple of other matches. Starladder's almost every single night this week. Sometimes we're covering it, sometimes we're not. And also Talk Dota coming up this Tuesday night, hopefully, if everything goes according to plan. Tomorrow, we'll release a news article with it all, and you can write your questions. We will have, hopefully, live in the studio, because he lives just around the corner, Kurikai, come and join me live here in the studio. So that is the plan, Stan, and we'll be back. The plan is another game, one more to go, and then we're off and running. Stick around. We'll be back.